A blister is fluid-filled space in the epidermis or immediately below the epidermis. Depending on the size, blisters are classified as vesicles when less than 1 cm in diameter or bulla, larger than 1 cm. In addition to fluid, blisters often contain inflammatory cells and/or epidermal cells. The vesicular dermatoses are classified regarding the location of the vesicle in relation to the epidermis, as well as the mechanism of blister formation. Regarding location, vesicles and bulla are classified as subcorneal, intraepidermal, or subepidermal. The intraepidermal vesicles are sometimes specified as superbasal when only the basal layer remains on the floor of the blister, characteristic of pemphigus vulgaris. Likewise, the subepidermal vesicles can be specifically classified as junctional when the split takes place at the basal membrane, usually in the lamina lucida. Bullous pemphigoid, and intradermal when all of the basal membrane is on the roof of the blister, epidermolysis bullosa acquisita. The blisters in epidermolysis bullosa simplex appear histologically as subepidermal while technically they are intraepidermal, being formed by destruction of the cells of the basal layer. Ballooning degeneration. Blisters ballooning degeneration implies marked swelling of the cytoplasm of the keratinocytes without associated spongiosis. The cells become rounded, lighter in color and detached from adjacent cells, becoming acantholytic. It is seen in viral processes, particularly herpes virus. Related to ballooning is reticular degeneration, characterized by marked edema of the keratinocytes that finally burst, forming vesicles in which thin strands of cytoplasm of the keratinocytes still remain.